We have next example. We have to solve this inequality. It means we have to find all possible values of z for which this inequality is true. Let me copy this example first. I have negative 2 over 3 z is less than or equals 7, 6 times z. Because we have fraction of both sides, I have to multiply both sides by common denominator. It will be 6. So 6 and 3 will reduce. We will have 2, 6 and 6 will reduce. So I have 2 times negative 2 will be negative 4z is less than or equals 7z. Now I will collect all terms with z on the left side. So I have negative 4z minus 7z is less than or equals 0. Negative 4z minus 7z will be negative 11z is less than or equal 0. Now, because I have to find on the left side only z, I have to divide both sides by negative 11. Negative 11 and negative 11 will cancel, and I have z. And always when we multiply or divide by negative numbers, we have to change the direction of inequality. So z will be greater than or equals 0. So let me draw the number line. Z, I have 0. 0 is included. And we're going to positive infinity. So our solution will be on the left side, close from 0 to positive infinity. This is our solution. Now I have to choose one number from this interval and check if inequality is true. So we can choose 1. For example, z is equals 1. Now I have to copy this example. I have negative 2 over 3 z is less than or equals 7 over 6z. Now I will replace z by 1. So I have negative 2 third times 1 is less than or equals 7 over 6 times 1. 2 third times 1 will be negative 2 third. Is less than or equals 7 over 6. As you can see, on the left side we have negative number and on the right side we have positive number. It means the left side is less than right side. So this inequality is true. So our solution is correct.